Welcome to My Conversation, a presentation of KAIL-TV, My Central Valley. So let's get My Conversation started.
Good morning, and welcome to another My Conversation on My Central Valley, KAIL. Once again, it's Feather DeWise, right there, somewhere it was. having a great week. Hope you guys are staying cool out there, man. It has been a scorcher for the past few days, but that's not going to stop us from bringing in great guests, like our first guest. If you can, please welcome, put your hands together for Michael J. Castle Photography. It is Michael
Castle. Hi there. Yeah, it is.
How you doing?
Nice to meet you.
Yeah. I'm so hot as frying my brain out of here,
I
man.
Tell you, I was just waiting for the air conditioner. I couldn't wait to walk in this building.
At least you were smart enough to wear short sleeves.
Absolutely.
You got me beat on that one.
Yeah, no, summer is just taking a toll on us already, but it's beautiful out there.
Now, with that, well, how does that make for it? We got plenty of sunlight.
Oh, I love it. Natural light.
And by chance, you're a photographer.
Absolutely. I love sunlight. I love natural light. I love that morning light. You know, I love that evening light. That way I can capture those photos. You know, when I'm going on my travels, sometimes the light's just perfect and I'm just kind of photographing all day. So it just depends, you know, where you're
that
at
is, that
and
is.
How everything's kind of working for you.
Now, which is your favorite? You got your portrait, you got your natural, sports, what is your favorite thing?
Well, you know, lately it's been travel photography.
Really?
I've been kind of really enjoying the portraitures and venturing out to some of these countries I've been going out to. So my last trek I went to, again, was Nepal. I did Annapurna.
Oh,
and so I'm traveling up to maybe about like 14,000 elevation. And I'm trekking and I'm taking photos and we're going through these wonderful villages. So it's quite interesting.
You say traveling up to, now that was by helicopter, escalator?
Walking with a 40-pound pack with all my camera equipment on me. And I have a porter who's helping me with my personal stuff. There's maybe a group of this time it was a large group. We had about eight people in the group. And then we had about another eight porters and guides and Sherpas. So it was quite interesting.
That and how long did that take from start to?
Well, this trek normally is a 10-day trek, but we had to do it in 8 days, so it was quite it was amazing. The first day, our flight to we're in Kathmandu, okay. So I'm in Nepal, and so we're gonna fly to from Pokhara, and because the airplane was not able to go because of the quality of the air that morning or the conditions, we had to take an 8-hour bus ride. So all eight of us got to know each other pretty well on that trek. But it was really interesting. But that kind of builds, because you really want to get to know the people that you're trekking with.
Okay.
You get to trust them. But then you also have the opportunity to go out and photograph and do things too. So, I kind of search those scenes and look for them.
That's incredible.
Yeah,
that's
really is.
That's not just a stroll through Woodward Park.
It's not a stroll through Woodward Park, and it's a lot cooler than it is right now. So I'm probably about like 40 degrees, maybe as Celsius, maybe like about 28. Okay, so in these 100 degree conditions,
yes.
I could not do a trek like that in this type of condition.
Yeah, right now that'd be way you couldn't trek in this heat, right?
Oh, not at all.
I mean, like walking from the car inside the building. Let alone.
I know exactly. So I said I couldn't wait to get from the building to the air conditioning in here.
Now, since you didn't, I'm assuming you just didn't get off into this. How long have you been shooting?
I've been shooting for like the last 7 or 8 years.
Really?
I think in the last 2 years, a little bit more serious as far as buying more equipment and getting those. Like I just, I took with me a 400 millimeter lens. I had a nice wide lens, a 16 to 35 millimeter lens, and I also have my 24-70. So I'm the kind of guy, when I'm trekking, I kind of stay in the back.
Okay.
So that I can kind of fall back and see what's happening and get those shots that nobody else is getting.
Maybe a couple of things they're not paying attention
absolutely,
to.
Absolutely.
Now, how did you, I know, and a little bit in common. I used to shoot. I used to call myself a photographer, just point click.
Uh-huh.
That's all I had.
Right.
Found the camera, loved it. Now, I know why I got into it. I got tired of other people taking bad headshots of me.
Right. That's understandable.
But, now, what sparked your interest?
In my late 30s, after my parents passed away, I was kind of searching myself, and I had to kind of figure out what I wanted to do for the rest of my life when I was growing up, right?
There it is.
And so I put myself through college. I was actually working in the national park, and so a lot of inspiration there. You have Ansel Adams, you have the whole wilderness, right?
Yeah.
And so I'm just trying to think, what do I want to do for the rest of my life? What is going to be encouraging? What is going to be uplifting for me? What is going to be creative?
Definitely.
because I'm a Libra and I got to be creative. I got to be balanced, you know, all the way through. And then that's where I started going back to school. I went to moved to San Francisco. I started attending the Academy of Arts University, put myself through school there, had a couple of jobs. And then I moved back to this area because during that time, it was about 2010, 2011, saturated market, right?
Yeah.
And the prices of San Francisco are going up. So I decided to move back here. I'm originally from Tulare, California. And I figured if I'm close to Yosemite where I want to be, I'll be right in the location that will work for me. And it actually has worked very well. I've been doing weddings. I've been doing nonprofit work. I've been doing corporate work, videography as well. So I love to tap into people. I like to tap into their minds and their emotions and really kind of connect.
Have camera, will travel.
Have camera, will travel.
Now tell us about the show you have coming up in July.
In July, last year I did a show called Learning to Breathe from my Himalaya trekking. And this year I'm keeping it the same, Learning to Breathe, but it's gonna be about the Annapurna and Nargacoat, okay? So Annapurna is a very well-known, mountain range that a lot of people do like to travel to. But I also went on to the western side of Nepal, went through more villages. And so I'm going to have a show, maybe about 30-some images. Last year, I think it was about 32, 35. It's going to be at Stellar Gallery in Oakhurst, because that's where I originate from. And it's going to be a wonderful show. It's going to be portraiture. It's going to be genre. I'm going to throw in some texture, and I'm going to do some landscape, and I'm going to give everybody a really a good foundation of what traveling in some of these countries is like. Because I think that it opens everybody's mind up to traveling.
Definitely.
Think it breaks down those walls of what we perceive other countries and traveling to be. And you know, so much with so much travel ban going on right now, it's nice to know that you can actually go to other countries and still feel safe in your travels.
Right. Now,
so
now that's going to be in July. So if they want to go ahead and for all your talents, if they want to hire you, if they get in contact with you and get more information about the show in July, what number can they reach you at?
They can reach me either at www.michaeljcosta.com. That's my website. Or they can go to 559-799-9632. Send me a personal text and I'll let you know when the show is. I'm aiming for July. I'm hoping it's going to be 6 weeks. And then in the middle of July, I'll be traveling to Peru, and I'm going to do Amsterdam and Portugal and Spain. So I have more to show you guys when I come back.
You're going to definitely have to come back and let us know.
Yeah, I do. Well, I really want you guys to know more about it. You guys are really going to enjoy the photos.
Definitely will.
I do this for not only me, but I do this for everybody.
And we appreciate you, as well as being one of our sponsors. If you could, please give it up for Michael Costa with Michael J. Costa Photography.
Well, great to talk with you. Thank you so much,
Feather.
I appreciate it.
You guys don't go anywhere. If you're watching, take a screenshot, a picture of your own. We'll be right back after these messages.
This episode of My Conversation is sponsored by Amy Ratliff and Jasmine Gray, Teamworks with Quality First Real Estate, and by Michael J. Costa Photography.